Hi everyone, welcome to JavaTechie. In our previous tutorial, we understand how to implement JWT based security in Spring Boot application, and also we tested same in Postman, right? So in this specific tutorial, let's build an Angular client application to access it. So if anyone not aware about Spring Boot JWT implementation, you can check out this specific tutorial. Also, I will add this link in video description so that you guys can refer it. So once again, let's test our backend application before we develop our Angular client. So let's get started. Let's go to our IntelliJ IDE. So we created this application, Spring Security JWT example, and I started the server. So it's up and running on port 9192. So if you'll go to the controller, we created two REST endpoint. One is the type post. So it will accept the request as a username and password. If you'll go to this authentication request class, you can see the attribute as username and password. Okay. Then based on the username and password, it will generate one JSON web token. Then if you will go to the next endpoint, this is the simple call, which is the get mapping. So the URL is slash, then you will get this response. As we implemented JWT security, to access this REST endpoint, we need to pass the JSON web token, which is generated by this API. Okay. So as part of request header, we need to pass the JSON web token to access this specific API. So I will show you in demo. Let's go to the Postman. So the first API, HTTP localhost, then port and slash authenticate. If you observe in body, I'm giving the username and password. Okay. So if you click on send, it generates one string token. This is what the JSON web token. Now I need to copy this entire token. Then I need to pass to the next API call. So our next API call is one get API call where the URL is slash. So let's go to the Postman. Let me add one more API. As this is the get API, in header we need to pass that JSON web token, which is generated by this post API call. So just go to this header, and here we need to specify authorization, and in value we need to set barrier, then add space, then pass the token. Then we can hit the endpoint. So if you observe here, we are getting the response, welcome to JavaTechie. Fine, it means our backend code is working as expected. Now let's build an Angular client application to access this Spring Security JWT example backend code. Okay. So first let's go to our Visual Studio code. Then here we just need to create one scratch Angular project. So we know the command how to generate Angular project. So type ng, then double hyphen generate new, then you can give the project name. So I'll give something called JWT ng client. Okay, then enter. It will ask you, do you want to use Angular routing? So as of now, no, we don't want. Then we want CSS. Then it will create the project. It will take few time. So our Angular project created successfully. Now let's move to the specific folder where we created our Angular application. So let me go to that specific folder, JWT ng client, right? Click on the select folder. So we are in our project directory. Now let's create one component here, ng, then generate component. Then we need to specify the component name. So I will give name called security. So if you observe, it created component.html and all the required file. Also it update in app.module.ts. So as we are going to do REST API call from this Angular client to our backend code, I just want to create one separate service. So for that, I can type the command ng generate, then service, we can give the service name. I'll give the service name called JWT client. Okay, then enter it. Yeah, so it created service also. Now if you will go to your src and if you will go inside this app, this is what the component we created and this is what the service we created, right? So as we are going to do REST API call, first we need to register HTTP client in app module.ts. So let's go to this. If you observe here in declaration, our component is already registered. Okay, so in imports we need to add HTTP client, so we can type it manually, HTTP client module, then let me close this. Yeah, then we need to add the import statement. Fine, so we are good. Now let's go to our JWT client service and then we'll route the REST API call logic. Okay, so go to this. First we need to inject HTTP client here. So what I will do, I'll route private, then I will give the variable HTTP client. Now let's write one method public, will return one string as a JSON token. So I will name this method name as generate token. If you observe in Postman, in our post API call to generate JSON token, we are giving this username and password as part of request body, right? So that's why I will just specify here request. Then we just need to return it and we will use HTTP. The API call is post. Okay, then here we need to specify the post API URL. So go to the postman and copy this URL. Then pass it. Then we need to pass the request body, which is our request. And then we need to specify the response type. So if you will check in our post API call, the response we are getting as a string. Right, so let me show you once again. Yeah, we are getting this token as a string. So what we need to do, we just need to specify the media type here. Okay, so go to the code and we just need to specify response type is text as JSON. Now add the semicolon, close it. Similarly, after getting this JSON web token, we can do the next API call, which is our get API call. So for that, let's write one more endpoint in our Visual Studio. Public. Then what we'll mention here, welcome. Here we need to pass the token as part of request header, right? Then I'll do the return HTTP API call is get API call. Then we just need to give the URL here. Let me copy this URL. Fine. So if you observe in our get API call, we need to pass this header, right? Authorization, then the JSON web token generated in our post API call, append with barrier, right? So this we need to specify in our get API call. So same thing we need to add here, then directly we can pass the token here. Okay, let me check that once again. Key we are giving as a authorization and then value. Go to the Visual Studio ID. So I will declare one string called token str, then I will add. So if you observe in post API call, we are just adding this barrier, then we are giving space, then we are adding this token, right? So similar way, we need to build our request header. So let me add it here. Yeah. Now you can append your token. Then we just need to create our HTTP header object. Headers. Then we just need to set the key and value. So if you observe, the key is authorization. Then the value is this token str, right? So now in this get API call, we no need to pass this token directly. We can pass this header, right? So better to name this as a headers. Yeah. And here I just need to set the response type as a text. Then I can pass these headers. Fine. So we wrote REST API call from Angular client to our backend code. But whenever we are writing client API call, first this client will do an option HTTP method call, right? That's the reason we need to enable cross origin in our backend code. So for this API call, first Angular will do an HTTP method, which will be option call to verify whether your backend API call is cross origin enabled or not. So in backend code, we just need to configure to enable this cross origin. So we can go to our IntelliJ ID. You can go to your main class and then we can annotate @cross origin. Then we can specify origin and we can disable it. Okay. But I found sometimes this approach won't work. So for that, what we need to do, either you can add this or else we need to add Spring Bean configuration. So there is a bean called, I will just add it. Yeah, so you just need to enable cross configure by adding this bean. Okay, so you will find this source code in video description, so you can use it. So I am using the bean approach. I will just remove this annotation because I found it's not working. I tried more than 2 times. Okay, apart from that, if you'll go to your security config, here we specify the art matchers, okay, for specific URL, and here you need to specify to our backend code, please support for the option HTTP method. Okay. So for that, what we can do, just we can add this permit all art matchers, then method type. So better to add dot. Yeah. Now it will permit all for all the HTTP method with type option. Okay. Then it will verify whether cross origin is enabled or not. Forcefully we enable for all the endpoint. That's why we add here star. Right, and we are allowing it for all the method, whether it is get, post, put, delete. For all, we are just disabling our cross origin. Okay, now we are good, but I guess one thing we missed again in configure, we need to disable cors http.co. Yeah, disable. Fine. Now let me restart our backend code. So our backend server is up and running on port 9192. Now let's go back to our Visual Studio code to update our Angular client application. So we wrote our service. Now let's go to our component. Okay. You just need to go to securitycomponent.ts. Then in that component.ts, we need to inject this service to access these two REST API call. So go to your securitycomponent.ts. So here I will inject this service. Service name is JWT client service. Yeah. Now let's write one more method here. Public. The method name, we can give the same name. Get access token. And we need to pass the request here, right? Request in the sense we need to pass the username and password. So what I will do, I will just specify one request here of type any, then I will add this JSON structure. Okay, so for this specific example I will hard code the username, but if you want you can add one form page to give the username and password dynamically. Fine, so here I can directly pass this auth request, and then I can call this. I'll first bind it to one variable, service dot generate token. I will give this authentication request with username and password. Okay, then this response I just need to subscribe, right? Subscribe. So first I just want to show you the JSON web token as part of log, so that's why I can directly write console dot log. So I'll specify like this token, then this one, right? So once we'll verify if you can see the log, means see the token, then we'll do the next API call. Okay, so first let's test this specific API. What I will do, I will just call this method from onInit. Fine. Now what we need to do, we created this child component, right? This component we need to register in our app component. So for that I just need to copy this selector, then go to your app component.ts. You need to go to HTML, then let me remove all this stuff, and even I don't want to see this image, just add your selector here. Fine, now let's run our application to verify whether we are able to get the web token or not in our first post API call. So I'll just start the server, ng-serve --open. So Angular code is compiled and server is up. So what I can do, let's go to the browser, type localhost 4200, then just inspect it. Okay, yeah, so if you observe here, we can see the token as we are adding it in log, right? This is what we are doing here. So if we'll go to this component.ts, we are just adding in log token, then the token we are getting in from post API call. That's what we can see in response, right? Now by giving this token, we need to access our get API call. So how we can do that? Let's go to our code and let me write one more method, public welcome. I can give any method name, better to give it get API call or access API, and here we need to pass the token, right? And whatever the response we will get, I just want to display in HTML. So that's the reason I will declare one more variable. So I will give the name response of type any. Okay, so once again I will declare one variable, let response equal to service dot, the method name is welcome, and here we need to pass the token, right? So if you will go to this welcome method, we need to pass the token, then we need to build the header by giving the key and value as token authorization and this token str. So the same structure, the way we are accessing in our postman, in same structure we just need to build the request header. Okay, that's what we are doing here, and we are giving the token. So go to this component.ts where it's giving compilation error. Okay, Now we need to subscribe it. Response.subscribe, get the data, then map it to response. Fine. Now better, instead of add log here, we confirmed here, appending this log, we are getting the token, right? Directly I can pass this token to this Access API call. So what I will do, I will just simply call this method Access API. Then I can give this token, right? So the way we are doing Java method call, same way I did, I just created one public method. It will just take the token, and the token will get by call this get access token method, and taking the request as authentication request. That authentication request contains your username and password. Now what we can do, as we bind those data to this string, so this string I need to add in our HTML file. So let me go to this security component.html. I'll add it here. So let's add some style here. So I'll give this blue color. Fine. Now save it. Save all the file wherever we did the change. Now let's go to the browser. Already you get the response. Once again I will refresh it. Okay, we can see the response. Welcome to JavaTechie. So this is how we can build our JWT Angular client application. Okay, that's all about this particular video, guys. Thanks for watching this video. Meet you soon with a new concept.